This is the final part of the shape keys tutorial. In this part, I'm going to show you how I lighted and textured this object inside of Blender and how this procedural texture is growing with the object. If you haven't seen the other two parts of the shape keys tutorial, you can find that in the playlist over here or over here, somewhere over there. So let's jump right into the tutorial. This is the animation we made last time in part 2 of our shape keys tutorial. I have made some keyframe interpolation differences, but it's basically the same animation. So let's start off by lighting this. I'm going to add a new HDRI. I'm going to select this Ctrl T, which gives us an environment texture. I am going to open up an HDRI I have. All these HDRIs I have downloaded from resources like this, and it is completely free. I'm going to select this one. So what I'm trying to do is I'm going to rotate this in such a way that we get a nice variation of bright and dark areas. Yeah, this looks interesting. Now let's go into texturing. I'm going to select this. I'm going to add a new material. For now, I'm going to set this to red. And because we have different objects swapping, we have to come in here and manually make sure that all these objects are sharing the same material so that they will be sharing all the materials in the end. And yeah, that looks good. And to easily scroll between the animation, I am using Alt and using my mouse scroll wheel, which allows me to easily move between the frames. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use a yellow color, and let's make this look a bit like concrete. And because these shapes are morphing, we can't use a PBR texture because the texture is going to stretch in very weird ways. So the only way to texture this is going to be by using a procedural texture. So I'm going to go for like a concrete kind of look for this. Going to add a noise texture. Let's preview that. Okay, that's how it looks. We're going to select this and hit Ctrl T and use the object texture coordinate. If you want to learn more about how texture coordinate works, check out this tutorial. I go in depth on how all these different texture coordinates work. So for this, I'm going to use object. So what it basically does is it is going to stick with the object no matter what. You can see, even when the object is changing, the texture is growing with it, which is the kind of look we want. It is not stretching with it, but it is growing with it. And right now, this is not looking like concrete. For that, I'm going to increase the roughness and detail, and that looks more like concrete. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take this, plug into our base color, and let's preview how that looks. Yeah, that looks pretty good. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a color ramp. And right now, this is a black and white texture. I want it to be a yellow ish texture. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to remap it. I'm going to select yellow over here, copy, paste it over here, and make this a bit darker, something like that. So now we are getting a yellowish kind of texture. So what basically this color ramp does over here is it is taking the bright and dark values and remapping it to lighter yellow to darker yellow. And if I preview it, yeah, that looks pretty good. But you know, like concrete isn't super flat, right? It will have a bit of roughness and bump as well. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a bump. I'm going to take this, plug this into our height and normal into our normal. And that gives us a super rough concrete. But I don't want it to be that rough. I'm going to scale the strength down a little bit. Yeah, that looks good. Think it should be a bit more rough. And now I want to add a little bit more detail into it. I want to add small dents into our material. For that, I'm going to take our noise texture, Shift D to copy it. I'm going to use the same mapping. Let's use Ctrl Shift left mouse button to preview it. Decrease the scale and detail of it and add a color ramp. I'm going to crush the dark and bright values somewhere over there. Scale this up. You can see the dark areas, right? It should create a dent into our material. So for that, I can use a bump again. Copy paste over here. Our color into height, and let's preview our bump. I'm going to scale it up. So you can see what is happening right now. It is creating all these dents in our object. I think the dents are super smooth right now. I can increase the roughness and also the detail a little bit. Yeah, that looks good. And if I feel the dent size is small, I can come over here and edit the color ramp, because this is controlling how big the size of the dents are. And now if I preview it, and this is a very simple procedural texture setup I have right now. If you want to learn more about how to create really awesome procedural materials inside of Blender, I have a course on it. So definitely check that out. And for the background, I'm going to use a cyan-ish color. And I think I can make the lighting better. Going to come in here. Yeah, that looks much better, right? Because there is a much more dramatic variation between dark and bright spots. Yeah, this looks much better. Yeah, I also think this can be a bit more brighter. Yeah, now this object really pops. Yeah, that looks good. And that is the end of the shape keys series we have. Thanks for watching till the end. Subscribe for more Blender tutorials.